Thank you for auditing the always positive new music review show hosted by a French professor who's still on vacation with his family. They just left to go find the pool in this Kafka-esque hotel. So they're going to be gone long enough trying to navigate the weird hallways and endless exit signs that I'll be able to do a quick review for Thunderground Thursday of Jackie Hayes' There's Always Going to Be Something. Now, I'm on vacation, I'm here in Washington, D.C., it's been quite nice, but I really wanted to stay with this Thunderground Thursday as much as I possibly can to spotlight albums maybe you haven't heard of, and I really, really enjoy this very quick EP. It's like 15 minutes, and it's filled with this great combination of sort of a generational combination. You know, I like thinking about that quite a bit. It has a lot of sort of upbeat Gen Z stuff going on here, a lot of kind of bright clarity, a lot of earnestness, but then it's mixed with a little bit of sort of my generation's kind of dry wit and a sense of sort of disillusionment. And there's a nice combination that all goes together. Apparently she was from Waukegan, Illinois. My sister-in-law, who I was visiting in West Virginia, tells me that's a very working class neighborhood near Chicago. I don't know what that has to do with anything, but it was just fun hanging around with somebody who's also from suburban Chicago. The best comparison I could make to this band, and I don't think, you know when bands sound like other bands to you, but you can't like say that they sound the same? You know, like I don't think that Jackie Hayes is directly influenced by The Strokes. I might even imagine that she doesn't listen to them or hasn't intentionally heard them in her entire life. But when I hear Jackie Hayes, I very much hear, it feels the same to me as the way I feel when I listen to The Strokes. Now, musically, it makes sense. There's a lot of very correct guitar lines, okay? So what makes The Strokes so great, in my opinion, is you know, great usage of melody and poppiness while still being very rocky and cool, but just correct guitar lines. And that's what we have here. A lot of very simple, like single note guitar lines that are just correct. And over all of it is her singing, which is very cool, charismatic, slightly detached. It does remind me a fair amount of Julian Casablancas, although she's probably a better singer. It doesn't seem like it's a full band, really. A lot of the drum beats seem automated, but they have this cool kind of compressed sort of junky loop sound to it. And the whole thing all together feels very kind of DIY, very kind of underground, but at the same time, it's jam-packed with catchy melodies, to where it's totally enjoyable to listen to for the entire 15 minutes. My stamp, which is my homework, my example song, I'll put a link to it up there in my weird hotel room here. What do you think that thing's for? I don't know. It's the song called OMG. I just like songs that are named after emojis. I think it's funny. But just have a listen to this song. You'll hear what it is. This great single note guitar line and just, oh my God, just this great high and low voice, the cool automated drums, a beautiful instrumental part with this distorted guitar. Gets a little bit more rhythmically interesting. The guitar and the voices are just flying all over the place. And all the way throughout, we have these great kind of lyrics of disillusionment. You know, let it go, it's not as fun as advertised, what a waste of time. I kind of miss lyrics of disillusionment. You know, that's a little bit out of vogue these days, so it's nice hearing them here. If you listen to that song, you'll hear what this album is about, what she's about, this kind of ineffable cool mixed with detachment, mixed with a real good poppy songwriting sensibility. The next track, brand new, kind of a funkier guitar line, a little bit more bass heavy here. She harmonizes with herself, which is quite nice. It's probably more vocally interesting, although maybe I don't think as good as OMG, and a great three-note guitar solo at the end. Again, correct guitar, you know. The best guitarists are the correct guitars, not the but just a three-note guitar solo that takes us out of this song. Then the next song, Have Fun, is all based around three guitar notes. This kind of like looping hook that then gets layered over. And then layered over. She's singing a little bit lower here, a lot more in that Casablancas range. And again, she's singing about failing to have fun, which is a big theme of this album. Very another simple guitar solo, some catchy oh woes in here. Next song, Material, a little bit more ambitious. A little more like the vocals, a little bit more forward, more lush sounds. It doesn't sound as much as like a guitar and a voice. It almost sounds orchestral, even though there's no orchestra. There's also more dynamics where things will drop out. And the lyrics are also a little bit more, it's unclear exactly what she's singing about. like material. It's always calling my name. I don't know what that means. It ends on a song called Sunday, which has a, it seems like a synthesizer lead going along with the guitar. So it feels a little bit less guitar led, which is nice. Very warbly. The whole album is very warbly. It's very effective at having a very clear voice and kind of warbly drums and warbly guitar and warbly bass. And the lyrics, I treat every day like it's Sunday. I don't know if she's making a reference to Marcy, every day is like Sunday. In this case, she's just saying she wants to do nothing. And this is cool because that's kind of like these songs in rounds. Like she'll start singing and then she'll sing behind herself and it has that sort of row, row, row your boat round feeling. The whole thing is just very pulsing and danceable. Like the entire song, the entire album, you know, I was getting ready to go. I had to move my car and I parked in this place called Union Station, which is like, it's weird, like seven layers of hell. Like you can't get out of the building and I ended up on the wrong street and I walked in the wrong way. But the whole time I was listening to Jackie Hayes, it took me an hour to go a half a mile. That was how serpentine and truly Kafkaesque Washington DC is. And I was just listening, and the whole time, even though I was like grumpy, and I was carrying, you know, I was carrying coffee for my wife, and I was carrying chocolate croissants for my kids, and I had hats going, and I had a sweatshirt, and it was like 90 degrees, and it was like muggy. I had this music going, and I was just kind of dancing along and happy the whole time. This is that kind of music. This can do that. Okay. Well, I assume by now they've found the pool. We'll see. I think it's way up there. You want to see? Want to see what this place looks like? Look at this. Look at all this. Look at all this craziness, right? Yeah. All right. Well then, until next time, where I'll hopefully be back home and doing a little bit more of a normal video. There's the camera.